That's a very expensive mistake.
Well, I was going to start the series off with a skit, but looks like I have some computer repair to do first. Hi there! I go by the online alias of Boo342. Or Boo342. Or BUU34. Just pronounce it however you want. And I'm a computer science student, aspiring to one day be thrown into the meat grinder that is the video game industry. If you're one of my almost 700 subscribers, you probably know me for either my Garry's Mod or my Doom work. But I've actually been part of the Nintendo 64 development community since around 2018. It might have caught you a bit off guard when I suddenly just dumped a dense 1-hour lecture about Nintendo 64 development on this channel. I've written guides, homebrew, tools, libraries, I've even helped organize two Nintendo 64 themed game jams. But what I've always wanted to do was to make a full-scale retail game. When you ask people what their favorite game for the Nintendo 64 is, you're probably going to get an answer like Super Mario 64 or Ocarina of Time, maybe even GoldenEye, or if there's someone extra spicy, they might say Starshot Space Circus FIFA. But those are all wrong answers. The best game for the N64 is a lesser-known title called Mystical Ninja 2 starring Goemon, or Goemon's Great Adventure if you live in the US, or
Gambare Goemon Derderu Dochu Omake Tenko Mori if you live in Japan.
Now there's a logo you don't see nowadays.
This game is a 2.5D side-scroller, and what really sells it for me is the flow. You'll notice that I'm never letting go of the right control stick. All I'm really doing is just timing my attacks and my jumps just right so I can essentially cut through this level like butter.
If you know anything about Japanese culture, you will probably be familiar with the monster design in this game, as it's highly reminiscent of yokai, which are the mythological monsters of Japan. There's a fantastic video in the Game Theorist channel about this that I highly recommend you check out.
Since I'm talking so much about this game, you can probably see where I'm going with this. I want to make a 2.5D side-scroller for the N64 with a focus on culture. Now, I intend on this project being completely free and open source. This is not something I'm going to budge on. I've also written a full design document about what I want this game to be about, so check it out, links in the description. Now, I do need to explicitly state this, but I'm going into this project with a few years of game development experience and Nintendo 64 development experience. It's really easy to get nostalgic for these systems, but they are not easy to develop for. You do not want to start a project of this scope without explicitly knowing what you're doing, and even then, I can't guarantee that my project's going to be successful, but I do think it's worth a shot. So you're probably thinking, that's cool, but why are you making videos about this? Well, you should have read the design document, but I'm gonna explain it anyway, because I'm such a nice guy. There is so much that goes into making games for these systems. So many difficult engineering decisions and hurdles that need to be jumped through, and I personally find it really interesting. I'm sure I'm not the only one who really wants to know what makes these systems work. The plans for these videos is for me to teach about game development, and specifically how games for these systems are made, in an accessible manner. I want people who have never coded in their life to be able to follow along with this project's development. I can't guarantee I'm gonna have a schedule for these videos. This is a game project first and foremost. Video editing takes a very long time, and especially in a system as complicated as the N64, I kind of want to have like good visuals to properly explain what I'm doing. That being said, if I do come to some sort of like difficult decision during the game's development, I want to have a video so that I can, you know, explain my reasoning and you can see the sort of things that the developers had to deal with. That, and I can also then be called an idiot as someone shows me a much better solution in the comments section, which I will begrudgingly have to accept when the project is crumbling under me. In all seriousness, I do also hope that these videos will help build up an audience, that people become interested in the project that I'm working on. And I hope you stay along for the ride too.